So this is Dora Smith with Siemens PLM, and I'm talking with Dan Staples.
Hey,
and Dan, when did you know that you wanted to become an engineer?
Well, I guess about midway through my freshman year of college. Strangely enough, when I was growing up in high school, I thought, you know, I have kind of an engineering bent to me, but I like to write, and maybe I ought to be a patent attorney, of all things, right? And so I thought that might be a good combination. I looked for schools where I could do, you know, sort of a pre-law thing and an engineering thing. So when I first went to school, my first physics class, I was in love with the engineering thing, and I just kind of said, okay, no more patent attorney, it's all going to be engineering. And that's when I first said, okay, this is it for me, I love engineering.
And so how did you kind of bridge from engineering, maybe being interested in products that you might patent, to actual software technology and more the computer science?
Well, it's kind of funny because it was more by accident than anything. You know, things happen this way, right? So I was clearly on a path to be an engineer. I was interviewing with companies like Bechtel and, you know, people I was in the Houston area. And then Intergraph came and interviewed on campus and said, hey, we want to talk to you about computer graphics. And I had spent a little time on the system. We had a really old computer vision system. And I thought that's kind of cool, so I'll talk to them. And they flew me out to Huntsville, Alabama, and on the screen they had tumbling shaded blocks. I'd been working in wireframe and computer vision. I was like, holy cow, this is the most amazing thing ever. And so just went from there.
So shaded blocks was all it took.
Shaded blocks is all it takes. That's exactly right.
And so so then you've been really with that organization ever since and involved with software technology.
Yeah, 28 years, a few days ago, as it turns out.
Oh, so, congratulations.
Yeah, it's one of those things. And when I got out of school, I thought, you know, put a couple years here, you know, move up the ladder, move somewhere else. But it was really both a great company to work for and highly addictive in terms of the computer graphics thing. So, and one of the things that I think is great is, like, mechanical engineering. It's, you know, it's a very broad kind of field, and I feel like I could always, you know, it adapted really well right into computer graphics. I felt like I could, you know, understand what other users wanted and bring that to them.
Now, did you, when you were in, you said you went to Rice University?
Yes, Rice.
Did you have kind of some of the project-related work that we see today? You know, we heard from some students yesterday that are doing this FSAE car.
I wish it was as hands-on then as it is now.
Yeah.
What we had that was really cool, though, is you had to take at least one semester of machine shop. So you had to learn to operate the lathe, and you had to learn to operate, you know, the machining centers. And you actually learned welding, both, you know, the flame welding, oxyacetylene, and the arc welding. So that was cool because that was hands-on. And then when we did our senior project, which for us was a robot, a mobile robot, you had to machine all the parts yourself and put them all together and stuff. So that piece, I guess, was pretty hands-on in retrospect.
So because of that early interest in patents, did you have you gotten some patents through your career that and written any patents?
Well, ultimately, a patent attorney writes the patents.
Yeah.
But I've been involved. I probably have about 10 patents out there, either pending or you know, granted at this point. And I got quite a bit of experience just in terms of kind of how you want to lay out the claims to narrow the field properly, but yet, you know, there's a lot of little details once you get into it.
So you can maybe be a patent attorney on TV when you retire from
Yeah, I'm not a patent attorney, but I play one on TV.
All right, thanks, Dan.
All right, thanks.